Letting go is like tearing a piece of your soul apart. It's watching the dreams you once held close slip through your fingers, while your heart aches with the weight of memories you can never relieve. How do you release someone or something that's been woven into the very fabric of your being? The truth is, we never truly learn how to let go, because it feels like a betrayal to our own heart. But sometimes, to heal, we must break, because only through the pain of release can we find the strength to breathe again. Today, let's explore how mastering the art of letting go can free us from the chains of pain and suffering in life. Namaskar, how are you all? I am Nandita, and you have already started watching It's Moonneel. Swami Vivekananda said, "Attachment is the source of all our pleasures now, and it will become the source of all our pain in the future." So, let's dive deep into the learning how to let go and embrace true freedom. To let go, we must first understand why we hold on. We often attach ourselves to people, things, or outcomes because they fulfill a deeper need or fear. Fear of loneliness, need for validation, or maybe it's just comfort in familiarity. Guru Gaur Gopal Das reminds us, "We are not the situations, we are the observer of those situations." So, my dear friends, take a step back, ask yourself, what am I really attached to and why? Once we understand our reasons, we can start working on letting go. Life is in a constant state of flux, my dear friends. Nothing lasts forever. Yet, we still hold on to the belief that things will remain the same. This belief causes our suffering. But what if we remind ourselves daily that everything is temporary? The pain, the joy, the people, and even our attachments. The Bhagavad Gita says, "Change is the law of the universe." And if we embrace this law, letting go becomes a natural process. We start realizing that holding on to something transient is like trying to hold water in our hands. It always slips away. We often suffer because we are too focused on what we lack, what we desire, or what we have lost already. But practicing gratitude brings us into the present, into what we have right now. Swami Vivekananda once said, "The more we come out and do good to others, the more our hearts will be purified and God will be in them." Cultivate gratitude for the present moment, for the little things, and slowly the need to cling to what is gone will disappear. One of the biggest sources of our pain is our expectations. We attach ourselves to how things should turn out, but life rarely plays by our rules, does it? We need to practice letting go of outcomes and focus only on doing our best in the present moment. Guru Gaur Gopal Das beautifully explains this by saying, "You have the right to work, but never to the fruit of the work. Don't get attached to the results." Letting go of expectations, my dear friends, helps us enjoy the journey rather than constantly worry about the destination. Mindfulness is a powerful tool for letting go. When we stay present, we observe our thoughts and emotions without any judgment. By simply being aware, we detach ourselves from the stories we create in our minds. It's like standing on a riverbank and watching the water flow by. You are not in the water, you are just watching it. Similarly, when pain or suffering arises, observe it without getting swept away. This simple practice, my dear friends, helps us see things more objectively and not hold on to them. Mastering the art of letting go isn't easy, but it's a journey worth taking. Swami Vivekananda said, "The less we think of ourselves, the better we become. And the more we let go of our attachments, the freer and lighter we feel." So, ask yourself, what are you holding on to today that no longer serves you? And how can you start the process of letting go? Remember, Freedom from pain and suffering comes not from holding tighter, but from opening your hands and letting go. If you find value in this video, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and share this with someone who might need it. Let's all learn to let go, step into freedom, and live life with a little more peace and a little less pain.